In this video, we are going to implement the logout functionality. We are going to keep this really simple. We are going to use the logged-in method that we have already created to conditionally render the login and logout buttons. And since our navigation bar is in the app component, open app.component.ts, and over here, first import the authentication service. So import auth service, and then inject it. Next, open app.component.html. Now over here, the register and login buttons should be visible only if the user is not logged in. So let's add that condition. We're going to make use of the ngif directive. And this is going to be equal to not underscore auth service dot logged in. Let's add the same to the register button as well. Next, let's add a logout button that is visible only if the user is logged in. So an anchor tag with the text logout. Class is navlink. We're going to add style, cursor as pointer, and then the ngif condition. The only difference here is that we want the user to be logged in. And finally, let's also add a click handler to log the user out. So on click, we are going to call the logout user method that is going to be defined in auth service. So go to auth.service.ts and define the logout method. Logout user. Within the method, we are going to say local storage.remove item. And then the item is the token. And once the token is removed, we are going to navigate the user to the regular events view. So for routing, again, we make use of Angular's router, import it, and then inject it. And in the logout user method, you're going to say this.router.navigate2/events. This is the regular events view. All right, let's save all the files and test it out. Go back to the browser. And currently, you can see that I am logged in because we do have the token set in the local storage. And because of that, we do not see the register and login buttons. We instead see the logout button. If I click on logout, you can see that the user is logged out. The token is removed from the local storage. We are going to see logout replaced by login and register. So let's go to login. Enter valid credentials, and we are in the special events route. If I log out from this route, you can see that we are redirected to the regular events route. So that's it. That is our Event Hub application. Nothing too complicated, but still focusing on the concept of authentication. Now, if there is any part of the application that you struggled to understand, I would say just rewatch the video 2 or 3 times. All right then, to wind up this course and to help you get a better understanding, in the next video, I'm going to suggest a few improvements that you can make to this existing application.